There is a world all around us that we simply can't see. But what if we could explore beyond the limits of our senses? Let's slow down time. Fix your gaze. Reveal the unseen. And don't blink.
I've never met somebody who doesn't have a sense of awe when they see a bird in flight. I mean, of course, we all can think of the Icarus myth or the work of Leonardo da Vinci. Long have scientists and scholars been dreaming about flight, been thinking about it, been trying to achieve it.
These kind of things are just happening too fast for me to even see. What I see is flap, 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 flap. And what's actually happening is flap, flap, and then pull the wings in and glide like a little ski jumper. When you work with these kind of animals that are small and they have such amazing speed of reaction, you can't even judge as a human being. The footage that I've seen has opened my eyes to how they're actually flying.
Good. All right, here we go. Bird's flying.
There's a moment when you're gonna get your shot. It's the moment when the bird can fly in a bit of light. It's the moment when we can get it in focus because the depth of field is about half an inch. Even though the image looks like it's flying slowly, it's flying fast. Faster than a camera can move, faster than a person can focus. So if it all comes together, it's just magic.
Bird, hit your light, hit your mark. Focus.
He's trying to figure out why the sun is on the ground.
The longest flight a migratory bird can do is 9 days without food or water and without stopping. We might as well think of them as flying to the moon.
There are so many open questions when it comes to trying to understand bird flight. There's still a lot we don't know about how turns are accomplished, about how birds avoid stall, which happens to airplanes when the wing encounters the air at too steep an angle. It can have a precipitous drop off in aerial performance and the plane can plummet out of the sky. Birds seem really good at avoiding that problem, and their solutions could be different depending upon different circumstances, and we're still trying to figure that out. There can be from several hundred to millions of birds in a single murmuration. it looks so coordinated that you might assume that there has to be an outside force, some guiding hand. Every individual within the murmuration seems to be equally important. There's no leader. Instead, there's simple decision rules. So it looks like individual birds are paying attention to, keeping tabs on, just how close their closest six or seven neighbors are. And when one neighbor has to make a change, that propagates from individual to individual all the way across the murmuration. Birds can move so quickly when they're flying. It's something that's simply awe-inspiring because of its sheer grace and sheer power as well. I think it's a universal feeling of awe.